In this video, we'll pull the parameters from a 1-horsepower GS2 drive using the free GSoft app and transfer them to a 2-horsepower GS20 drive operating in GS2 mode using the free GSoft 2 app. So go to the Automation Direct website and search for GSoft and download it, and then search for GSoft 2 and download that. Install both programs. Connect your PC to the GS2 drive using this USB to 45 converter, and connect your PC to the GS20 drive using a USB A to B cable. You'll need to apply power to the GS2 drive so we can connect to it. The GS20's control electronics run just fine from the USB cable power, so we don't need to apply line power to the GS20 drive. On the GS2 drive, make sure these switches are set to RS45. You'll want to know what the GS2 COM port parameters are set to, so I'll go to parameter 9.0 and note that the address is 1. In parameter 9.01, we see the baud rate is this, and parameter 9.02, we see the protocol is this. Start GSoft. Now you can approach this using any of these options, but I'm just going to close that and connect directly to the drive. Bring up the computer's device manager and look for this Silicon Labs UART. That's the USB 45 converter we're using. We see it's using COM14 on my PC. It'll probably be different on your PC, but whatever it is, put that here. Now we just have to make sure these match the drive settings we just gathered. Hit connect. GSoft tells us we're connected and good to go. Hit the upload button to retrieve the parameters from the drive. It warns us that we're about to overwrite whatever's in GSoft right now. We don't care, so I'll hit yes. This is going to take around 60 seconds, so I'll speed up the video. As it reads the parameters, it notes which ones are not set at the default value. And those are highlighted in red when we get the parameter list. GSoft is asking if we want to save our parameter file. Yeah, we do. Give it a name and hit save. Now that we have a saved version of the 1-horsepower parameter file, we can change it to be compatible with our new 2-horsepower drive. So we go to Utilities, Change Drive Rating. Here you can change the drive rating to whatever you want. We want a 2-horsepower GS2 drive. And we need to select the firmware version to match the new GS20 drive. The firmware version of the GS20 drive in GS2 mode is in parameter 9.39. I know mine is 1.07, so I'll select that one. That'll update all of the associated parameters to make this a parameter file that's compatible with our new 2-horsepower GS20 drive in GS2 mode. Save it, give it a name, and hit OK. Close the upload dialog. So now we have a full set of 2-horsepower GS2 parameters with the correct firmware version. Bring up GSoft 2 so we can talk to the GS20 drive. Remember, GSoft is used to talk to GS2 drives. GSoft 2 is used to talk to GS20 drives, even when they're in GS2 mode. Let's put this GS20 drive into GS2 mode by setting parameter 0.02 to a 2 and then to a 20. We now have a GS2 compatible drive with GS2 factory default settings. We want to connect to the GS20 drive. Since the GS20 uses a dedicated USB port for configuration, we don't need to worry about any of this stuff. We just need to make sure the COM port is correct, mine is still at the same COM11 we used in a previous video, and that ASCII is selected. Now that's important. Because we just put the GS20 in GS2 mode, it initialized the drive with GS2 factory default settings. And GS2 factory default uses ASCII, not RTU like we're used to using with the GS20. Again, for all practical purposes, this is a GS2 drive with factory default settings. Hit COM test to make sure we got the right port. Yep. Connect. Give it a second or two. And we see we're now connected to the GS20 drive. If we click on the parameters button and read the current parameters from the GS20 drive, we see the GS2 parameter groups 0 through 9. The GS20 normally has parameter groups 0 through 14. That tells us our GS20 drive is definitely in GS2 mode. Let's open our GS2 parameter file, which is a GSC file, and hit OK. Remember, this reminds us we're looking at the file parameters. If I click here, we see we're looking at the drive parameters. I'll click back on the file parameters, and normally we would modify the motor parameters in this section to match our new 2 horsepower motor. I don't actually have a 2 horsepower motor here to get the numbers from, so I'm going to skip that and hit write all to send the new 2 horsepower file parameters to the drive. GSoft 2 gives us the opportunity to deselect any parameters we don't want to write. We'll leave them all checked and hit write. Give it a second, and we see all of these parameters got written, and there are no parameters that failed to write. Perfect. Hit OK, and reread all the drive parameters. Well, that ought to be enough to get you started with transferring your old GS2 parameters into a new GS20 drive that's in GS2 mode. Which is really cool, because now you have a higher performance GS2 drive that's smaller and costs less. Now, one caution, the user manual reminds us that while the GS20 drive in GS2 mode uses all of the same parameters, there's always a chance that the improved performance may affect some of your operations. So be sure to thoroughly test your new GS2 drive before deploying it. When you're ready to start using all of the GS20 drive's features, check out this video, which shows you how to migrate from the GS2 drive to a full-featured GS20 drive. Click here to learn more about the GS20 family of variable frequency drives. Click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you're notified when we publish new videos. And click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free award-winning support options.